हेलो एवरीवन, आवर चैप्टर इज चैप्टर 9 ऑन सोइल और नेचुरल रिसोर्स. ऑलरेडी वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट दिस. व्हाट इज सोइल? इट इज द टॉपमोस्ट लेयर ऑफ द अर्थ. नाउ ऑन अवर अर्थ इन डिफरेंट एरियाज यू फाइंड दैट देयर आर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ सोइल फॉर्म. देयर कलर्स आर डिफरेंट, देयर टेक्सचर इज डिफरेंट एंड देयर क्वालिटीज आर ऑल्सो डिफरेंट. दीज ऑल डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ सोइल आर because these soil particles are made from different types of rocks, and on our earth there are different types of rocks are formed, like sedimentary rocks, granite, etc. So the soil which is formed of which type of rock, it will has a property or related with that type of rock, and in this manner there are different types of soil are found on our earth. Now on the basis of their size of the particle and some basic properties like water holding capacity, aerosity, etc., the soils are divided into major three groups, and these three groups are semi soil, clay soil and loamy soil. Now we will not only explain all these three types of soil but also differentiate between these at the same time. So with the help of this table I will explain you what are the basic properties of these three types of soil. Now, first property we will take composition. That means what type of particles are consist in these types of soil. First, semi-soil. Semi-soil consists 60% sand and at least less than 10% clay. In clay soil, 60% clay particles are found and which are very fine particles. Now in loamy soil, 40% sand, 20% clay and 40% silt and humus are available. That means loamy soil is a mixture of both these types of soil. That means both type of particles are found in this type of soil. That's why it is the best soil for the plants. Now, the size of particles. In semi-soil, the size of particle will be nearly about 0.2 millimeter, while clay soil has very fine particles and it is nearly 0.002 mm only. While in loamy soil, as the both type of particles are found, so we will consider the medium size of particles and it will be between 0.002 mm to 0.2 mm. Now, if we talk about texture, in Hindi we call it banavat. What type of particles are actually, how do they look? If you take this type of soil in your hand and if you will try to feel the structure or texture of these particles, you will feel that the sandy particles are gritty and they will slip down from your hand, and you will feel that these particles are loosely packed. Now, if we talk about clay soil, these particles are very fine, very close to each other. So you will, as you take powder, any type of powder in your hand, like talcum powder, paste powder, etc., you will feel that this is very smooth. So when you touch, clay soil is also feel smooth, and if water is also added, it will be sticky also at the same time. Now loamy soil, this is smooth and gritty because it contains more type of particles in it. Now, aerosity and water holding capacity. Aerosity means how much air is held by these types of soil, and second, water holding capacity, that how much water they can retain. Now, as in semi soil, the size of the particles is larger, as you can see in the picture. These particles are large in size, and between these particles, the interparticular space is more, and as the interparticular space is more, more and more air can be held there. And while if you want to drop some water on sandy soil, you will observe that this soil cannot retain water for much time, and most of the part of water which you will drop, pour on it, it will come down, it will percolate down. Now, so we can say that the air holding capacity of sandy soil is more, while water holding capacity is very less. Now, in clay soil, as these particles are very fine and the interparticular space is very less in between them, so less air is found in between with the clay particle, and the plants which are growing in such type of soil, their roots will not obtain the proper oxygen for breathing. Now, the water logging capacity is more of clay soil, so it can hold more water, it can retain more water in it. Now, in loamy soil, as the medium sized particles are there, so both the air and water are available in enough quantity, and that's why it is best suited to the plants. Now, we talk about fertility. In sandy soil, as the water, it cannot retain water, so the minerals and nutrients will also not be available to this soil. They will go to the water table, and that's why the soil is not much fertile and vegetation is found less in such type of soil. Now, in clay soil, more it can retain more nutrients due to more water holding capacity also, and the minerals which will come down from upper layers of the soil, they will reach to this soil and it can retain many nutrients, so it is fertile. In loamy soil, enough nutrients are available for growing the plants. Now, in this sandy soil, many few plants can grow in this type of soil. Only such type of plants can grow which has strong roots, and these roots can go deep inside the soil and can reach up to water table, because these plants can obtain water from water table only, because this soil cannot hold much water. So, it's for growing crops, this soil is not much useful, but for construction work, sandy soil is very useful. Now, in clay soil. In clay soil, as the water holding capacity is much, so cereals and many vegetables and paddy also can grow in this soil. And second thing, when we add water in it, lumps can be made from this soil. So, this soil is also used for making different pots. Now, loamy soil. Pulses, lentils, cotton, etc. All such type of vegetables and other crops also can be grown easily in loamy soil. But those require less water, because though it can hold water, but not as much as clay soil can. Now, we discuss about some properties of soil. Texture of soil, guys, already we have discussed in this table that sandy soil has gritty and loose texture, clay soil has a smooth and sticky texture, while loamy soil has a smooth and gritty texture. This type of texture, if you want to feel, you can do an activity. For doing this, we have to take different types of soil samples of all these three, and when we want these particles in our fist, we will feel such type of texture in it. When we add some water, we will feel that this clay soil is sticky, while other soils are not as sticky as the clay soil. Now, percolation rate. For percolation. Percolation means seeping water from the soil. When we pour some water on the soil, how much water it can hold and what amount of water goes down from that soil, that is called percolation. To calculate the percolation rate, we will use this formula. Here, amount of water which we are pouring on that soil is divided by the percolation time. And to calculate the percolation time, we will do another activity. Here, in this activity, as you can see in this picture, here three funnels we will take, and in these three funnels, we will keep different types of soil. In first, sandy soil, then clay soil and loamy soil. And now, equal quantity of water we will pour in all these three funnels, and they are kept on measuring cylinders. In this activity, we will observe that how long they will take for this percolation of the water. And the last drop which will fall down from this funnel, we will calculate the time up to that. In this manner, percolation rate will be calculated. And by calculating this percolation rate, we will observe that percolation rate will be faster for sandy soil, it will be medium for loamy soil, and it will be least for clay soil. Now, water holding capacity. Here we use another formula, x minus y multiplied by 100 divided by g. Here x is the
volume of water poured into soil sample. That is how much water you will pour on that soil. Where it is calculated in milliliter. Here it is x. Now from this amount, this quantity of water, we will subtract the quantity of water which we collect in the measuring cylinder. That means the water which has been come out from the soil after percolation. So this difference x minus y is actually the water absorbed by soil. This will be divided by the amount of soil taken, and this is taken in grams. Now we will multiply it by 100 so that we can calculate the water holding capacity into percentage. In this manner, water holding capacity of any type of soil is calculated. Now moisture content of any soil. How much moisture is content? For doing this, we will take some amount of soil and we will add some water on it to make it moist. Now we will weigh this moist soil and take its weight in grams. After that we will dry this soil, and after getting dried or completely, we will again weigh the soil and we will take its weight in gram. So the difference between these two, weight of moist soil minus weight of dry soil, this is called moisture content of the soil. That means how much maximum amount of moisture can be held by this type of soil.